Right blessed are they which are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said to me, this truth has been uttered of God, and I fell at his feet to try and worship him. But he said to me, don't do that, for I am of your kin. I'm fellow servant and brother in the testimony of Christ Jesus. Give God worship and testify of He. Of Christ Jesus is the Spirit of which is prophecy, and I saw the heavens open, a white horse did I see. He that sat upon him was called the Faithful and the True, and he judges in righteousness and makes war in virtue. His eyes are like flames of fire, on his head many crowns, and no man knew his name, but he was his name written down. He was clothed with robes dipped in blood, his name the Word of God. His troops of saints that were with him on white horses and clothed in fine linen made clean and pure, thereby his righteousness. Out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, that with it he would bless and smite nations. He shall rule them with the rod of iron. The scepter of authority of the angelic ones. He treads under and makes a path the winepress of anger, and indignation of his wrath, everlasting Father. He has written upon his cloak and inscribed on his thigh, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and Son of the Most High. The marriage supper of the Lamb is not the very end, but is a calling that by faith throughout this age do send. This supper is one called for those who will then drink his cup and follow him in his sufferings, they then to be filled up. I now things for you I do fill up. Though sufferings which do remain to the lack of his cup. Those afflictions to be fulfilled within my mortal flesh. For the body of Christ Jesus, and therein put to rest. Assembly of fellowship for the Ecclesia, that we are all in gathering to the supper of God, that we all gather and partake together in his sup, and with him in his afflictions take part the marriage cup. If you don't drink the bridal cup, you cannot be betrothed, nor feast upon his bread and wine, in righteousness be clothed. If you do not drink of his cup of suffering in his blood, then you have not by covenant betrothal that you should. Then you will not be of the bride married to the bridegroom, nor find yourself under his skirt, nor in the upper room. Not only are we invited, but the feast has begun. The wedding feast of the Lamb is established in the Son. For it has been establishing for the last 2 days of 2,000-year days of God, which he bids from above. I bid you come unto my feast with wines upon the lees. Grace in the age of forgiving of prideful harlotry. Come unto the wedding supper and drink of my Son's cup, and join with him in covenant in his affliction sup. This is the wedding of the Lamb that the Father ordained, that we would partake in this world and of our lives disdain, and by faith walk in the kingdom and pick up your own cross and follow him as we rejoice in that which we count loss. To lose your life in this world is to enter in by faith. The Lord's table and wedding feast, and do this without haste. The testimony of this saint is that we do not love our lives here and to give it up to be with him above. These ones are as gold to the Lord, by their trials are found within the feast, drinking his cup as a bride to him bound. The bride at her wedding Sukkot must take the bridegroom's cup and take his oath and drink of it, that he may take her up unto his father's house, their home, and then for 7 days must be hidden and sequestered and be with him always. In the kingdom this supper is as a blessed union, but for those left upon the earth is the wrath of the Lamb. And then I saw a messenger, him standing in the sun. He cried with a loud voice, saying to the fowls flying in, "Heaven, come and gather yourselves to the great God's supper, the supper of Almighty God and of our great Father."